Live, the talk of the town on the East Coast is here in LA this weekend.
We're celebrating
National Pizza Day. It's a match made in heaven. Dominic Moreno, you are the co-owner of Prince Street Pizza. And let me tell you, the links, the videos, everything about you on the internet made me so excited to see it in person. Thank you for being here.
I'm honored.
You have a very strict technique to your Sicilian pizza. Why is it the talk of the internet and the talk of the East Coast?
I think it's the talk of the internet because it's just such a unique slice and it's just done so well and it's done with such love that people just appreciate it so much and what I'm doing and what we're trying to do.
True to a Sicilian pizza.
Yes. And people get confused with Sicilian and Detroit and deep dish.
Right.
They're all
thick crust.
Exactly. Yeah. But Chicago deep dish is more like a casserole to me. It's very deep. It has a lot of cheese.
Detroit sounds a little insulting almost.
They're fine.
It's like a
they're
casserole.
Fine. They'll be fine.
They own thick crust, so
they have
fine.
To call Chicago pizza because it's not pizza.
It's not pizza.
You know what we call pizza in New York?
What?
Pizza.
Pizza.
But the main difference, a lot of people will confuse it with Detroit style. The main difference between Detroit style and Sicilian style is we have the thickness with the Sicilian, but Detroit styles, it's a little bit smaller and it's in a little bit of a deep cast iron pan. It's in between a deep dish and a Sicilian, and they put regular mozzarella instead of fresh mozzarella. Mm-hmm. They put it on the corner so the corners burn and you get that burnt crust.
Interesting, but not with you.
No.
And also, tell us about this dough, because I know it's thick, but it's not like a casserole.
No.
It's almost like a focaccia, right?
That's the best way to describe it. That's the closest thing that I tell people what it tastes like. But I've tried a lot of Sicilian. If you ever tried a lot of Sicilians, you'll notice that some Sicilians that you get, they're very doughy, they're very mushy, and it's very blobby in your mouth. That's not what I try and go for. I try and go for a very crunchy bottom, but also a very airy middle, like focaccia.
Ah, so famous people have been doing pizza reviews on the internet.
Mm-hmm.
What, if I were to hold up this slice, what would I be looking for? Do I want the droop? Do I want the middle? Because you said you want it to be doughy. Like, that's a nice slice of za right
Pretty
there.
Pretty perfect.
It's not bad.
It's got a little bit of, what am I looking for in a good slice of Sicilian pizza?
You're looking for a good crunch, but you're also not looking for a very heavy, doughy slice.
Okay. And this looks pretty beautiful, like a piece of art.
Oh my God.
So why are you here in Los Angeles?
We're doing a pop-up shop on Sunset right now.
Love it. So Sunset, your landmark is the Hustler Building.
That's the only way I know to describe it. I don't know LA like
that's
that.
That's okay, that's okay.
But Sunset Doheny and Doheny.
Sunset would be a good way to put
in
it.
In West Hollywood.
And it's a collaboration with...
I just don't want to get all over my suit.
That's okay.
Be right back.
You look nice and sharp for our Oscar coverage today.
Thanks, I'll be right back.
Off the menu and okay. Prince Street Pizza are doing a pop-up. So now until Sunday at 2 a.m., so I guess it's Monday at 2 a.m., you can get a slice, and if you are a member of Off the Menu, it's an app, and you get to accept a free slice. So if you're a member like I am, go claim your free slice. It's super fun. $6 per slice. Now, you have two different kinds here, the Prince Perfection and the Spicy Spring. I'm scared of spicy, but is it going to burn my mouth off?
The pepperoni's a spicy one.
The pepperoni's a spicy.
It's not that spicy, also. Right. I mean, it's like
no, it's wonderful.
Good. It's got a good kick
it's
to it,
good,
but it's not going to like
I'm talking,
good,
so I can't eat, but you're over there enjoying the whole thing.
I mean, I took a huge bite. You know, they always tell you don't eat too much on TV, but I don't listen to they. So it was very good, though.
But if you can't get down to the pop-up, Uber Eats is doing exclusive delivery. And why should people make it a point to try this? We got a lot of great pizza in LA, I'm not going to lie. But while you're here, why should we make it a point to eat your pizza?
Well, this is a one-of-a-kind slice. There's no other pizza like this out here. And there was no other pizza like this back in 2012.
In New York.
Me and my father, when we opened up Prince Street Pizza, we are the creators of the pepperoni Sicilian slice.
Wow. So, do you expect it's going to be totally slammed?
People
are going to be like waiting for a long time to get their pizza.
I really hope. Last year when
are you going to run out? Like, is there going to be a time?
At some point, we're going to run out.
Yeah.
But when we did it last year, it was about 4 hours long, the line.
And get out of here.
No, I swear to God.
You could fly to New York in 4 hours. Well, I guess.
Yeah. You have a really fast plane.
It was during Grammy weekend last year, and Childish Gambino actually waited online for three hours.
What?
To get in. And then he hung out with me for like another two. He was a really nice guy.
Yeah, that's awesome, man. That's so cool.
We've seen videos of you online making the pizza and how your style is in the flat cast iron.
Yes.
What's your technique?
Well, first you get your cast iron pan.
Mm-hmm.
I use soybean oil for my pans because I feel like it gives the best burn and doesn't overburn the dough. You take a paintbrush and you mop it up on the cast iron pan. You take your dough, you mm-hmm. flop it, you mm-hmm. press it down, turn it around. You pinch the corners,
press
you
it
let
down,
it rise.
Turn it around. Yep.
Mm-hmm. You let it rise. You put the cheese first, then you put the sauce, then you put your layer of pepperoni on it.
And you do slices of mozzarella. You don't do the shredded.
Exactly.
Okay.
On the regular slices, the only one that has the shredded mozzarella. Everything else is fresh mozzarella.
Oh my goodness.
And then you put a little bit of pecorino, pop in the oven for 10 minutes, you're good to go.
That's delicious. That's so tell us about the food scene as far as you see in LA. Obviously, like, we've never really been known for pizza in Los Angeles until like the past 10 years. Like, really, pizza started like, getting really good here.
I've been out here the past, last year, they're like maybe about 5 times. Every time I come out here, I always want to try Mexican and Japanese.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Like, those are like the big ones.
Yes. Food scene. We have a lot of really good food from the East, for sure. A lot of really good food from Mexico as well. But we're working on pizza. Are you going to make a permanent stay here at any point?
I don't know. Only time will tell. I'm looking into some spots now, but nothing's guaranteed.
All right. Well, but what is guaranteed is that it'll be exciting this weekend.
That it will. That
Sunsini,
it will.
Sunsini and Doheny.
Yep, that's it.
That's what
Sunset
it is.
And Doheny. So get your slice. Again, this isn't like, you know what I like is that you're coming in and you're not charging me $15 for a slice of pizza.
Yeah. No, that's crazy.
Thank you, LA. Listen to this man, okay? It's not crazy. It's just really
good.
Hey,
listen,
good food.
The working man has to eat too. Man or woman.
Yeah.
Or whatever you prefer.
I love this paisan
in the room. He speaks to the people. So go check it out. We'll have more information on KTLA.com and also Uber Eats if you can't get to the physical location. Dominic, thank you so much for being here.
It's been my pleasure.
But now
I've had
a
great time. We're going to have some more pizza.
Enjoy, enjoy. I've eaten it too much. I can't eat that much.
But when they curl up.
You don't look like it. Come on. Oh, the curled up pepperoni. Oh.